Hello folks, this is Markus Steinmetz and me. We are consultants at Kugler Maag & Company. My name is Sebastian Schröder. I'm an expert in functional safety in automotive for more than 10 years. I've been familiar with risk analysis, safety concepts, and the implementation of safety management processes at the organizational and the project level. Today, I would like to talk with my colleague Markus about the touchpoints of functional safety and cybersecurity in automotive.
Sebastian, I will gladly accept the ball. My name is Markus. At Kugler Maag, I work primarily on cybersecurity and autonomous driving. Functional safety and cybersecurity both belong to the overall safety of a technical system. But within this approach, both have different concerns. While functional safety is intended to protect human life and limb from faulty systems, cybersecurity protects the system itself. The reason? At its best, cybersecurity makes it impossible for an attacker to take control of your car or any kind of information, especially data that is critical from a financial, operational, or privacy perspective.
First of all, that was a great briefing, Markus. What does that mean for practitioners? Do they combine cybersecurity and functional safety in their projects, or are those two separated areas?
We are taking a closer look at that now, Sebastian, but I would like to add one thing. When we talk about cybersecurity in our discussion, we have in mind such organizational measures as management systems, roles, responsibilities. Technical measures, especially encryption, are part of the routine work. They are, of course, elementary for cybersecurity, but that is what practitioners understand by this term. You know, these three phases on the board from functional safety, starting with the concept phase of a vehicle or function on the left, followed by the development and validation phase in the middle, and concluded by the post-development phase. The latter includes production, operation and maintenance, and the end of the vehicle's service life. In the center, you will find the V model, which is familiar to all automotive engineers. In preparation for the work of developers and engineers, on the left, hazard respective threat analysis in the concept phase serve as the basis for decisions on product architecture and technical concepts.
At first glance, these phases appear identical to our approach in functional safety.
Certainly, there are several touch points, which is why we are here together. But the purpose, scope, and level of detail vary from case to case. The long post-development phase will make these differences clear. To illustrate the interdependencies on the complexity of the interaction, I prefer that we look more closely at the phases of the product lifecycle.
With pleasure. Okay, so in functional safety, the concept phase is the domain of the car maker, the OEM. Part 3 of the international standard ISO 26262 describes this phase in detail. In the concept phase, several tasks must be accomplished from a functional safety perspective. First is the item definition, second, an impact analysis if required, and third, the hazard analysis and risk assessment. Number 4 is the functional safety concept.
In ISO SAE 21434, the item definition is also our starting point. We use it for the initial threat analysis of the asset in question. At the end of the day, the concept phase starts with a threat analysis and risk assessment and results in cybersecurity goals and claims. It describes how to put the cybersecurity goals into practice. The goals are first converted into requirements and then mapped to the product architecture.
In the functional safety concept, we also map safety requirements to systems for implementation. So, I assume that functional safety and cybersecurity start very similarly, right?
Yes and no. I agree that item identification is an excellent starting point to both of us. That's truly essential is the debate between the experts. When they put their hands together, they may discover conflicting requirements. For example, in functional safety, an unlocked door may be considered safe. In contrast, open access is a horror for cybersecurity.
Ouch. Okay, so let's talk about the most important analysis procedures, HARA and TARA. In ISO 26262, the hazard analysis and risk assessment specifies how to judge and evaluate the risk of electronics in road vehicles. Here we consider only damage that can injure a person physically. This is how HARA is performed for functions at the vehicle level. Risk assessment means that the occurrence of a hazardous event is evaluated according to the severity of the injury, the frequency or duration of the operating situation, the so-called exposure, and the controllability of the situation. The identified risk level allows us to identify unreasonable risks while we define and perform mitigations to reduce the risk level to an acceptable level. An automotive safety integrity level, an ASIL, is established for the resulting safety goals.
We are not in the same ballpark here. In functional safety, you refer to probability. You can estimate the occurrence of a hazards event using a derived probability formula. Cybersecurity, on the other hand, involves a high degree of uncertainty. So we are talking here about the likelihood of a threat occurring. In the initial threat analysis, we determine a risk value. This is derived by crossing two factors: the impact of a damage scenario with the feasibility of an attack path. Once we have identified and assessed a risk, we need to decide how to tackle it. If you intend to reduce the risk, you must establish cybersecurity goals like safety goals. Some goals can be addressed at the organizational level. During the life of a vehicle, we need to rerun risk assessment part of the TARA several times. The reason for this is due to uncertainty. For example, do we know that a future attacker will have stronger tools to break an encryption? Even in the operational phase of a vehicle, we need to update the risk assessment when we encounter a vulnerability or incident. So, there is no safe state in cybersecurity. Cybersecurity per se is not static like functional safety. Indeed, cybersecurity is a moving target. That's also why the UNICE organization insists on updatability. Software updates are the only way to ensure that your vehicle is highly protected throughout its lifetime. Unlike functional safety, there is no equivalent to ASIL in ISO SAE 21434 either. If you are going for it, the only way to address requirement is with quality assurance measures, even if that's not sufficient in this case.
Okay, I understand that in the practitioner role, we need to share our experience and communicate our expectations at a very early stage of product development, right?
Absolutely.
The software engineer must adapt the development process to the requirements of ISO 26262. This involves avoiding software faults through systematic development and implementing safety mechanisms. That is, they must break down the technical safety requirements from the safety concept to the qualitative software safety requirements. Then, these requirements and the safety mechanism must be implemented in the software architecture. Not to forget, engineers have to analyze the dependencies between software components. And for proper implementation, they need to follow coding guidelines.
This sounds very similar to what is expected from cybersecurity perspective. We also rely on rigorous development process. Requirements and other measures are documented in the cybersecurity concept. Now they become part of the engineer's duties. To deal with that uncertainty, we must do something. ISO SAE 21434 expects us to keep an eye on the risk assessment with each refinement. Supporting processes, especially configuration management, will be even more important in cybersecurity because of dependencies between the different components.
That's a very good point, Markus. In functional safety, we also heavily rely on well-established supporting processes like configuration management, requirements management, and change management. Disciplined engineering is key. But let's look at the other side of the V model. Let's have a look at testing.
Yes, we can prove that the specifications are implemented. Unfortunately, we can't prove that they are sufficient. But we can perform fuzz and penetration tests. While this is not mandated in the ISO SAE standard, it is the best way to achieve a robust state of cybersecurity. Since there is no ASIL counterpart in ISO SAE 21434, you should rely on best practices from other industries.
But the best state of safety is worthless if you use unreliable parts from your supplier. ISO 26262 expects us to coordinate our activities with our own suppliers.
Right. We arrive at the same conclusion as in the concept phase. It's all about communication. Coordinate your internal activities from the beginning and do the same with your partners.
In production, I assume our activities are similar. We have to make sure that the right data is in the software, which means we have to control configuration and calibration data.
Sure, but in cybersecurity, we also must protect the relevant production environment, including the operations technology and the backend systems. At the end of the day, it doesn't make a difference whether an attacker gets into the car directly or takes a circuitous route through third-party systems. I would like to emphasize one point that is different in cybersecurity. To make a car secure, the time after the start of production is just as important as the production development itself. There is no such thing as safe state. Let me put it very casually. In functional safety, you can mummify the car after production. Sure, you can perform field monitoring that becomes active when there is a customer complaint. But that's about it. Your car is the way it is. Cybersecurity is another story. Maybe a future attacker will find a new hack and we are back to square one. Until the end of the service life, we need to invest time and effort to keep the vehicle secure and provide updates when needed. That's why you need management systems with policies and responsibilities for cybersecurity and updates during the post-development phase. You need to set up continual cybersecurity monitoring. You might call this entity a security operations center. These folks keep their eyes open for threat information. That's why TARA should be viewed as an independent and iterative process outside of the V model. TARA is not limited to development. There are certain criteria to repeat the risk assessment when a new vulnerability comes to light. In the event of an incident, the Cybersecurity Center follows standard operating procedures on how to handle such a case.
Agreed. And to add one more thing, functional safety only works as long as the system remains stable. In a connected world, Safety relies on cybersecurity. Without it, safety is nothing. So I understand why we need continual security efforts. It reminds me a bit of DevOps, doesn't it?
DevOps, or even better, DevSecOps. I like the idea. That's a great conclusion.
Let's summarize the touch points between functional safety and cybersecurity. As common starting point, the item definition compiles all known information about the system, its environment, boundaries, interfaces, and functionalities. It serves as a basis for both analysis, HARA and TARA. Another important touch point is risk management. The perspectives of functional safety and cybersecurity are complementary. Both benefit from each other's findings. Also, structured product development processes are crucial. In the post-development phase, there are also activities during production and operation. In cybersecurity, there are continual activities required. And last but not least, a major aspect is the alignment between those two domains. Communication is key. That's all, folks. If you like this video and if you're interested in more specialist topics in cybersecurity, functional safety, and automotive spies, then subscribe to our Kugler Maag YouTube channel. And don't forget to recommend our videos to your colleagues. See you soon.
Kugler Maag & Company is engineering made smart.